Today we're going to tie a personal favorite fly of mine. With autumn approaching, leaves start turning colors, I start looking to the Golden Retriever. Golden Retriever is a product of Jim Finn from Mossy Creek Outfitters. One of probably the most productive patterns for large fish I've ever got my hands on. It accounts for the largest fish I take almost every year. From smallmouth to steelhead to trout, from spring creeks to the Susquehanna, this pattern is just a deadly pattern. You can fish it as a standard woolly bugger, which in rights it is, or you can fish it as a nymph, which I do. I fish it 90% of the time as a nymph, drifted under an indicator. Set the depth to be as close to the bottom as I can, if not bottom bouncing, with an indicator, and it is just a deadly fly. Here's how we tie it. Start off with a size 10, standard streamer hook, and a gold tungsten bead. You're going to begin by wrapping an underbody of lead wire. Start at the point of the barb, point of the hook, and wrap all the way forward. This is a heavy fly, requires no split shot to fish. It's down fast, stays where you put it. You can drag this through the water column like you would check nymphing, or just dead drift it and it'll get to the bottom. Wrap your lead wire forward and then seat it behind the bead, locking it in place, which will move it closer to the midway point of the shank. At that point, start your red 3/0 thread. I use red 3/0. The original pattern, I believe, is tied with flat wax. Flat wax works excellent, actually makes the pattern easier to tie. It ties faster because it builds up quicker. But I use so many other patterns that I tie so many other patterns that I fish with 3/0 red that I use what's available in my box. And you're going to wrap forward and start off by giving a good base wrap over your lead. Just want to cover everything. And then bring your lead back to the point of the barb, or thread back to the point of the barb. At this point, you're going to tie in tan marabou. Sweep the tips, the marabou quill. You're going to tie this about 1.5 lengths the shank. Tie it in at the rear of the hook. And you're going to wrap it forward to the beginning of the lead. And then at that point, bind it down. That'll help with that transition. Get rid of it. And bring your thread back to the point of the barb. Do another over wrap to cover up any spots you see. This doesn't have to be done perfectly. This is by far, it's a non-technical fly, if you want to say that. However, it's a very effective and easy to reproduce fly. At this point, you're going to tie in your estas. That's your rib or your hackle. And I use peach estas. And you're going to tie it in just behind that transition. And then over wrap everything. At this point, you're going to build a good level base. Try and get it as level as possible. If it's got a little dip or a valley in it, really doesn't make a difference. It's not going to affect the performance of this fly at all. That's strictly for the aesthetics and to make yourself feel like you have better tying abilities than you may have. then you're going to palmer your rest as forward. You're going to leave about a 16th of an inch between each wrap, keeping it snug. Wrap it all the way forward. And bring it up behind the bead. And trim off your excess. Now, just take your fingers and sweep most of that S-Daz fibers back. If you don't have them all back, I do not slow down with this fly when I'm knocking them out. I basically give a few wraps and then whip finish and throw some head cement on it. This is a very nice pattern to reproduce. You will go through them on the stream. The fish will hit them. And if you're fishing them correctly, you will be losing them on the bottom as well. And if you got a few loose fibers that just bother you enough too much to leave them there, trim them off. And at this point, you're going to throw some head cement. Be a little liberal. This fly will fish hard. You don't want it to come apart on you. Give it a good coat. I use Sally Hansen's. That's pretty much all I use on any of my flies. And there you have it, the Golden Retriever, an effective fly originated by Jim Finn. It has been knocking out fish ever since it left his bench. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it adds to your box. Have a good fall. Thank you.